Hello everyone, this is Pearlina with Pearlina's Precious Pretties, here with the second segment to my tutorial on how I use my Silhouette Cameo Studio Designer to prepare, cut, organize, and develop my 12 by 12 two-page layouts. And here, what you see are all of the elements that will be included in this layout that I will be creating, minus the Squeakheart candy box and one mouse to show you in a demonstration on how I put them together. So basically, I did say that I was going to do a start to finish, piece by piece, glue down and show you how I put this together, you know, just element by element. But I had something occur where I actually created a layout previous to this one, and I will post a photo of that layout at the end of this video. And I did every nose, every ear, every eye, every heart, every letter, every tail on video, and it took me about 3 hours to put that start to finish together. And it ended up taking 289 gigabytes up on my hard drive. And I have a 500 gig hard drive, so when it came down to editing the video, it was impossible. My computer froze up. It shut down a couple of times. It just didn't allow me to put it together. And I tried for about a week and a half, and then I came to the conclusion that I was not going to be able to edit that video. So I went ahead and deleted it, and I just started a new layout. And here is the parts of that layout here. You may hear my kids in the background. There's a house full of children right now. I have my children here and my husband's children, or my stepkids, here as well. And they are just playing in the halls and making a lot of noise. And they may be in and out, so excuse the interruptions ahead of time. So let me just tell you here what I do have. I have here are the four photo mats that will be part of this layout. The outer edge of this photo mat is 6.75 inches, and it will hold a 5.25 by 3.75 inch photo. And you can put your photos under this little slot that I created, and I have a tutorial on how I made these. It's the video previous to this one, or you can click on the link in the description box below to watch the video on how you can create these photo mats as well. And here is the third, or I should say, one of the four photo mats that will be added to this layout. Okay. I also have some trees here that I cut out. I used a file that I found on Silhouette America online. It was called the Cute Tree. And I went ahead and cut that out. I cut out two. There's going to be a total of four on the layout. There's going to be one tree in the middle, and then there's going to be two halves of the tree on the edge of the layout. Here are some additional elements I'll be adding. I have some grass here. These are some clouds and a sun. All files from Little Scraps of Heaven Designs Field Mouse Party file, and I will put a link to that file below. It's a really nice file, and these elements are great if you're trying to add a little bit something, you know, a little something extra to your layouts. Here I have four borders. These two are for the top, and these two are for the bottom. They are 12 by, I would say, 1.5 inches, because this is 1 inch, and I would assume this is about a half of an inch long and wide, and these will be on the tops and on the bottoms of the layout. Here are some little sweethearts. They are actually stickers that I got about 2 years ago. They were from Recollections, and they stopped making them. I made a layout previous to this one. It was an album actually about 2 years ago, and I used all the pink hearts, and I just had these hearts in my stash and haven't had a use for them until now. So I'm really happy that I found a use for them, because they were just sitting in my drawer, and they will be going on the tree and basically acting as heart fruits, or the fruits of love. on this these trees here. And I thought that was a really nice additional accent. Here is the Squeakheart, I'm sorry, the Sweetheart box of candy. And on the front cover, you see here that there's a piece of, it's not acetate. My husband sells cards on eBay, and these are penny sleeves. They're acid free, and he uses them to send his cards out when he ships them. And I just thought it was perfect to put on the front of this box to act as that little piece of plastic that comes with the Sweetheart boxes. And I thought it was really neat. And last but not least, here are the mice that are included in this layout, and I'll let you get some close-ups of them. There are a total of three boys and three girls, and the noses are glossy accented, and I will be showing you how to use the glossy accents to add to your layouts as well. Okay? That's one of the boys. That's one of the girls there. And the mouse I'll be demonstrating with you, or to you, is the, see if it'll focus. Nope, I'm not that lucky. The mouse that I'll be demonstrating is a girl, and she will actually be holding the Sweetheart box. And here is another boy, and you can see the glossy accent there on his nose. Another one of the girls. And here is the title with the mouse attached, and all of the letters on this title are also glossy accented. Okay? And this one as well. So let me tell you everything you're going to need to create this layout. You're going to need all of your pre-cut pieces, your poster board and your cardstock. You're also going to need your ATG gun or whatever strong rolling adhesive you have. You can use any adhesive really, but for certain parts of this layout, I wouldn't suggest using it because it may cause the paper to welt on the layout. You can also use, or I will be using, my Aline's Original Tacky Glue. If you get a good look at that. Got this from Michaels. I will also be using my Extra Strength Craft Bond Glue. I got this from Walmart. And please do not get the repositionable one. It is no good, in my opinion, for this type of layout. You will also need some glossy accents. These are glossy accents by Ranger. Found these at Michael's over by the Tim Holtz Distress Inks. You're going to need some sort of container to put your glue in, and you're also going to need a paintbrush so that we can work on adhering all of our pieces together. You're also going to need your fine, ultra fine tip black pen. This is what I use to create the eyelashes for my mice. A pair of tweezers and a pair of scissors. And like I said earlier, the next segment I will be taking these parts and gluing them down so that you know how to glue them down, because the process that I use for these is the same process for everything that you see here. So in the next segment we'll be doing that together. Thank you so much and stay tuned. Hello everyone, this is Pearlina and I am back with the second portion to this video where I will show you how to glue down your cardstock and your poster board together so that your pieces have more strength and dimension for your layouts. So first we're going to start here with the box for the Squeakheart candies. And what you're going to need is either your craft mat or somewhere where you can glue your pieces together without making a mess. I just use a piece of white paper, and you're also going to need your craft bond glue. And I did say, hopefully, before that you can get this at Walmart. Okay? So go ahead and open it up. And all you need to do, basically, is take that glue and work it around the edge of that piece of the poster board. Just like that. And it's really strong, really sticky, and it's a permanent glue. And then you just take that piece of the cardstock or designer paper and you just glue it on, just like that. You can use the back of your hand to push it down. And that's it. That's how I put those together. I do this rather than use the Aleem's glue and the brush because it doesn't whelp. And it's a very permanent glue. So then, now for the mice. Or the mouse, I should say. So what you're going to need, of course, is your craft bond glue, your Aleem's original tacky glue, your tweezers, the paintbrush, and that container for the glue, your fine point black pen for the eyelashes, and your glossy accents. And we'll be using this for the nose. Okay? So I'm going to put these all to the side. And the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to take the glue and squeeze it into this cap. You don't need a whole lot, but I'm just going to have it ready for when I put the layout together. So then what you want to do is, now these pieces are already glued down. I already have all of these parts glued down, so I'm just going to go ahead and perhaps maybe put this sideways. There we go. Okay, so these are all already glued down, but I did not glue down the head so that I can show you how I glue it down. And first, what I do is I take my craft bond glue and I do the same thing with this as I did with the heart box, but instead of using the back of my hand, I use tweezers. You could use the back of your hand for this piece because it's big enough, but like with the smaller pieces, I use my tweezers. So I'll just show you what I do there. So I go ahead and just put those two pieces together, and then I take my tweezers and like these fine parts here, I just go ahead and I squeeze them down with my tweezers. Just like that. Okay? And there you go. And the reason why I do that instead of using my fingers, like right now I use my fingers, is because over time, as I start adhering everything, the glue just starts getting everywhere and it gets on my fingers too. And I don't like to have the glue on the front pieces of my creation, so I end up using the tweezers to kind of keep that from happening. Okay, so now what I'm going to do is start piecing the mouse together. And this is just really easy. I take my brush and I just figure out what I want to glue down first. So I'm going to go ahead and do the inner parts of the ears. Let me see if I can get you to see this a little better. There we go. The inner parts of the ears, and I take my brush, I dip it in the glue just a little bit, I pick up one of the inner pieces of the ear. And one of the pieces of, I'm sorry. Please excuse the noise. I'm so sorry. They are out there having a ball. Okay. And then I take the ear and I just dab some of that glue and brush it on the back of that ear, just like that. Then I take my tweezers and hold the ear and I put it as best as I can. I'm going to zoom in just a little. Kind of better. Oh. You know what? It's not going to let me zoom in. I have it on a different setting because, oh yes, I love there it is. There we go. Hopefully it's still clear. Okay. And then I'm just going to take that and I'm just going to put it right in the center of that ear, just like that. Then I'm going to pick it up, use my tweezers, and squeeze it down. You can use your fingers too if they're not sticky yet. Okay, so now I'm going to do that with the next ear. Hopefully we're not losing too much focus here. Okay, so I pick up that inner part of the ear. I take my brush. Brush it on the inner part, the glue. Take my tweezers and push it down in the center of that ear. You can use your tweezers to adjust it a little bit. Okay, so now I have the ears done. Then, what I like to do next is get my face in order for my mouse, and then I'll glue the face down to the ears. So, the parts of the face include the eyes, the muzzle, the nose, and the mouth. Okay? So let's get it put down together. So first, I'm going to take the muzzle like this, put it on its backside or face it with the back facing towards me. That's where I'm going to apply the glue. And I'm just going to add a little bit of glue right there. Then I'm going to take that mouthpiece, grab my tweezers, and attach or basically pick them up with my tweezers if I can. And then I'm just going to take that piece that I picked up and glue it down to the lower portion of the mouth there. Just like that. Okay. Hopefully you saw that. Okay, then what I'm going to do, and glue's starting to get everywhere now, is I'm going to take the nose. These are really fine, intricate pieces here. They're so small. Take my brush, dab it in my glue, just a little bit, and add it to the back of the nose. Just like that. I'm going to grab the nose with my tweezers, and then I'm just going to put it on top of the muzzle there. Try to center it as best as I can, and push it down. Okay, so there we have our muzzle, we have our head, and our ears. Then what I'm going to do is I'm going to add some glue just to the bottom portion where the mouth is, because I'm going to slide the eyes, I'm sorry, just to the bottom portion where the mouth is, because I'm going to slide the eyes under the muzzle when I put it on its face. So I go ahead and just add some glue here. And then I line the mouth up with, I suppose, the chin of the mouse. And then I just push it down. And kind of like, don't push this down as much as you push this side down, because you want to be able to slide the eyes under. So this is what I do when I'm doing my eyes. I usually put it, take some of that glue, I pick some of it up, and then I put it right here on my wrist. You can put it anywhere really, but I feel like I have more control with it there. And so then what I do is I pick up one of the eyes with my tweezers and make sure the textured side is up, which it isn't here. Okay. And then what I do is I just dab a little bit of that edge in the glue, just like that. Then I'm just going to squeeze it in right between where the muzzle and the nose connect and push it down, just like that. And I like to put on my little toe. I think they're cute. Tilt it in a little bit. And then I'm going to do the same thing with the other eye. I'm going to grab it with my tweezers. I'm going to flip it over because I have more control on my right side. And then I'm just going to go ahead and pick up some of that glue. And then tilt the eye. Pick up the, oops, this nose isn't drying straight, is it? And slide it in under. Just like that. You can take your tweezers to adjust it before it dries. And this glue does dry fast, so be aware of how you're putting everything down. Okay. All right, so there you go. Get her eye just a little more adjusted there. Okay, and then what I do is I adjust the ears to where I want them to be, and instead of attaching one ear at a time to ensure that they're centered, I go ahead and I add glue to the back on each side where the ears would glue down of the mouse's head, just like that. Then I just take my mouse, I find the center, and I put it down, just like that. And so now my mouse's head is done. Now I'm going to let her dry a little more before I add the eyelashes. So while she's drying, I'm going to go ahead and add the glossy accents to her nose. And this is it's a dimensional, a clear dimensional medium. And basically, you don't want to shake it up. You just want to bring all of it down to the bottom. Just let it come down to the bottom. Because if you shake it up, it ends up with bubbles. And when you squeeze it out, those bubbles can end up on whatever you're glossy accenting. So be sure not to shake it up. Just let it all just come down. Then you just want to open it. And just squeeze it out onto whatever you're glossy accenting. So I'm putting it here on the nose, and you just want to get it all over the nose, and it takes the shape of whatever you're accenting. Just like that. And you want to just go ahead and put that to the side and let it dry. It fully dries in about an hour or so, and it'll spread out along the piece that you accented, which is good. It won't like drip off over. So that's how I did that. And I'm going to put that to the side so I can get her body put together. So here is her internal, or her is the inner part of her body here. This is her tail. This is her thigh. Her feet. Her arms. And her hands. And now with this portion, you want to be able to be sure to be looking at your photo of the image of her so that you can make sure she's not distorted and kind of align it with the photo that you are looking at. So what I'm going to do first is go ahead and figure out what part I'm going to work with. And I think I'm just going to go ahead and start putting this thigh down with the foot. So let me go ahead and get that photo up. Okay. And now I'm going to go ahead and take my brush, dip it in my glue, and I'm going to put it on the inner part of the thigh because that's the part that's getting glued down. Take my tweezers and just go ahead and lay it down, just like that. Now I'm going to go ahead and attach her foot. I'm going to add some glue just to the top portion. That's the part that's getting glued down. And I'm going to go ahead and just put it right there. Probably tilt it down a little. Okay. And then I'm going to take this foot, and I'm actually going to add glue to the back side of the body because I don't like to add glue to the cardstock because when I squeeze it, sometimes it squeezes out or it doesn't go exactly where I wanted to put it. So I go ahead and I'm just going to add a little bit right here. And then I'm going to take the foot and sort of slide it in and under. Now I'm going to take the tail, add a little bit to the back side of the glue, add the glue to the back side of the cardstock, figure out where I want my tail to sit, and go ahead and just push it down. Okay. Then, now, I don't necessarily need to add these hands because they're going to be behind the box like this. She's going to be basically holding it. But just for the purpose of having them here and not wasting them, I'll go ahead and add them. So I'm just going to add a little bit of glue to the back side again where her arm would go. And go ahead. That down. Now I'm going to add this arm after I attach her to the box. It's probably not. There you go. And then just add a tiny little bit of glue. Oops, almost put it on the cardstock to the back side of her hand. And there you go. There's her hand. It's probably not realistically like that, but like I said, it's going to be behind. Okay, and so then this is where I would add her head. Actually, I would add her head after I attached her to the box. So I'm going to go ahead and just attach her to the box now. But let me go ahead and put her eyelashes on. So that way I don't have to fiddle around too much because that glue is still wet and I don't want to mess with that glossy accent too much. So make sure that your pen is running and you can do this however you like. I really can't explain too much what I'm doing here, so I'm just going to do it and then, you know, you can do it however you would like. I just basically, oops, her eye isn't all the way down. Let me go ahead and make that better. when I moved it earlier, it dried too fast. Surprised no one's come in yet to tell me they need something or complain. Let me see, I'm going to do this off camera. I don't want to make a mistake here. Okay. So we'll just start the other side while that side dries. And basically, I'm just going to take my pen and run it along the edge. The eye, just like that. Just bring it around. I don't go around the whole eye. Then I put a little point at the top. A point a little bit off to the side here. And then another little point. I'm going to do that to the other side now. Hopefully it's set. Excuse the noises my husband's making. He's a Gemini. He's not very patient at all. Okay. I'm just going to add the point to the top here. That side seems a little more fuller. And there she goes. Eyelash step. Okay. Okay, so now what I'm going to do is I'm just going to go ahead, put her to the side, and attach the mouse to the box. Okay, so what I'm going to do is add a little strip of glue to the back side of this box. And you can use your ATG gun if you want. I'm going to pick her foot up slightly and just slide it right on her there. Straighten it out a little. Okay. Okay. And if you want to hold it, it takes about 30 seconds for it to adhere. Oh, her hand came off. Yay. Okay. Okay, and then what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and add her hand so that it can be holding the box. This is her arm. And here's her hand. Then I just take some glue and add it to the back side of her head, mostly on the side that's going to glue to the box and right under her chin so that it can adhere to her neck. Take my tweezers, and I like to put their heads at a tilt. And there you go. Hold that there for about 30 seconds. Okay, and I'm going to go ahead and add some glue to the back side of the tail or on the front of the tail so that she can glue down to the tail too. hold it there for about 30 seconds or so, just until it picks up and fuses with the paper. And there you have it. You have your mouse in your box attached, and I showed you how I glued everything down. So in the next portion of this video, we will be putting the layout together. I'll see you in just a moment. Hello everyone, this is Pearlina, and I'm back with hopefully the last segment to this tutorial on how I use my Silhouette Cameo Studio Designer to create my two-page 12x12 layouts. And here, I did forget to mention that you are going to need some sort of a background to lay your pieces down on. What I have are two pieces of the Basil Basic Dotted Swiss blue pieces of paper, and I believe the item number is T7-7131 at Michael's. And excuse again my husband and my kids in the background. They are just, it's Saturday, and you know, they have the weekend off, so they're having fun. So I'm just going to go ahead and start putting everything down, and I will probably be fast forwarding through parts that I don't necessarily need to say anything, but if I do need to, I'll stop it and tell you what I'm doing. Okay, so right now, what I usually do when I'm creating the layouts is I sort of just position everything where I think I want it to go, so that way I get an idea of where I'm going to be gluing everything down. Okay, and if you would like a tutorial on how to make these borders, let me know. They're basically pretty much like making the photo mats, except you just go straight across. And I start the cut in the middle of one of the little scallops, or whatever these are called. And that way, when I put them together, they sort of line up. Okay? Alright, so now I'm going to go ahead and position my mats. I'll start with the back. I was a little concerned that these trees are kind of short, and I'm hoping that the grass will compensate for that height, because I wanted them to be above the mats. There we go. Okay. So, like I said, I'm just doing the positioning. I'm going to go ahead and start the fast forward here. Okay, so here, right here, what I'm going to do is I'm going to basically let you know that I'm going to be cutting these apart, because when I put the photo mats down, it's going to cover a great deal of that, and then I can use that to extend out into the rest of the layout. So that way it looks like there's grass behind the whole thing, even though there isn't. Okay, so I just want to stop and let you know that. I'm not going to cut them right now, but I'll be cutting them shortly. I'd be walking alone with nowhere to go, quietly doing my thing. Then came the sight of an energy shining so bright. As you closely walked by, your eyes met with mine, making me feel so alive. Finally found me my Okay, so this is pretty much just a rough draft of what it's going to look like. how I'm going to put it together. And it is a lot more stuff. I probably put more stuff than I should have. But, you know, the grass is going to come up here for so that, you know, there's the trees are on top of something. And here are the little sweetheart fruits for the trees. So basically that's how it's going to come together. So in this portion now, I'm just going to start gluing it down. And what I do is I'm going to start, I'm going to use my ATP gun, and I'm going to put down the borders. And then I'm going to position the grass the way I want it positioned. And then I'm going to use my ATP gun to, I'm going to use glue to put the trees down. And then possibly I'm going to have to use some dimensionals to pick the mats up off of the layout because there's a lot of dimension on these trees. So we will see when we get there, okay? So I'm going to keep going.
Still see you the same way, 'cause through these trying years we wanna both physically change. Now don't you know you'll always be the most beautiful woman I know. So let me reassure you, darling, that my feelings are truly unconditional. See, I'll love you when your hair turns gray, girl. I still want you if you gain a little weight, yeah. The way I feel for you will always be the same, just as long as your love don't change. No, I was meant for you and you were meant for me, yeah. I'll make sure that I'll be everything you need, yeah. Girl, the way we are is how it's gonna be, just as long as your love don't change. 'Cause I'm not impressed, more or less, by them girls on the TV and magazines. 'Cause honestly, I believe that your beauty is way more than skin deep. It's everything about you makes me feel I have the greatest gift in the world. And even when you get on my less nerve. I couldn't see myself being with another girl.
I'll love you no. when my head turns red.
Yeah.
We gotta make it. Soft like the wind, I'll caress your tongue.